Hi friends, welcome to another session of C programming. Today's program is there will be an array of structures. So the structure contains student details like name, roll number and grade. We have to read a roll number from the keyboard or from the user. Then we have to check the roll numbers of all the students. So if that roll number matches with the roll number of any of the student, we have to print name and grade on the screen. So this is the program or this is the task. So here it is a program. So here you can see that struct student. So we have created a structure called student. So which has got three members, name, which is a character array. Then an integer variable roll number and a character variable grade. So grades can be grade A, grade B, grades and all that. So this is end of the structure. So this is main function. Inside main, we have declared an array of structures. So struct student, yes, with size 5, that means we want to store the details of 5 students. So we have created an array of structure students. I is the loop variable and roll number is the value that we want to read from the user. CL or SCR is a function, predefined function that clears the screen in Turbo C. So first we need to read the values from the programmer. So for that we have to declare a for loop for I equals 0, I less than array size that is 5, I plus plus. So here you can see that we are asking for enter student percentage D, name, roll number, grade. So here the percentage D is, I want to print a string like enter student 1 name, roll number, grade. So percentage D will be replaced with I plus 1 value since I started with 0. So 0 plus 1 is 1. So it asked me like enter student 1 name, roll number and grade. Then I will enter all the details. And for the second iteration, it will ask me enter student 2 name, roll number, grade. So that is a string that I want to see on the screen. So that's why I have used a string something like that. So for reading, we are reading only two values here. That is a string and roll number. Okay. And the string that is the name of the student is taken into s of I dot name. So here you can see that structure variable is followed by an index that is I, because this is an array of structures and it is a name. So no need of using ampersand, but roll number is a normal value. So that I have to use ampersand s of I dot roll number. So why I didn't put a grade here is because when you are entering these values, so after entering roll number, if you click on new line, that is enter, so enter will be taken as the grade. So it doesn't read or doesn't wait for you to enter the grade of the student. So in order to avoid that, I have used a predefined function called fflush-stdin, which is a predefined function that clears the buffer values, that is the slash and character from the buffer. Then the grade is reading by using the getCHAR function. So s of i.grade equals to getCHAR. So this entire body of the for loop will read name, roll number and grade for all 5 students. Then I want to check whether all my 5 student details are stored or successfully read or not. So for that, I want to print all the details. So all student details are, then for loop, then I am printing name, roll number, grade of each and every student. So here you can see that s of I dot name, s of I dot roll number, s of I dot grade, but print all the name, roll number and grades of each and every student. Then the main task, that is so checking for a particular roll number, if that present, we want to display his name and grade on the screen. So we are asking to enter the roll number here. Then the roll number is taken into RNO. Then from the first structure to last structure, we will compare this roll number with all the roll numbers of the stored student details. So if roll number is equals to s of I dot roll number, that means we are checking from the first student to the last student. So whenever there is a match, so it prints percentage D's, that means so and so roll numbers name and grade is so and so. And as soon as it is found, so we'll break the loop, we'll come out of it. Okay, so if the no results are found, that means I is 5. So in that case, if I equals to 5, then we'll print percentage D not found. So this is the program, my friends. So it's very easy program. So now move on to the execution part. I've already created the program. You can see here. this is the student structure, this is the array of students. So with for loop we are reading all the values and then we are printing all the values, then we are asking for the roll number, then you read the roll number and start comparing with every student. It founds from print the roll number names and grade, and if it is I equals to 5, that means the specified roll number is not in that list, so we'll say that percentage is not found. So let's compile this program. No errors and no warnings. Start execute. So enter student 1 name, roll number, grade. I'm entering my name, roll number and grade, and second name, roll number, grade, roll number, grade, roll number, grade, name, roll number, grade. So I have entered all the 5 student details. So we'll see that all the 5 student details are stored or not. So all student details are, so senior roll number 501, grade A, Ram roll number 502, grade B, and all that. You can see and every student details. Now I am entering the roll number. So I will enter Vishnu's roll number, that is 504. So 504 name is Vishnu and grade is A, so which is absolutely correct. So this is for the match. Again we'll execute this. Now we'll give a roll number which is not in the students list. So re-enter their values. This is the grade, and the last name, last roll number, and this is the grade. So see all the details of the students here. Now I am entering a roll number which is not in there, that is 507. So 507 not found. So this is a program, my friends. So this program will read a student roll number and checks with all the stored student records, and if the roll number match with any of the student's roll number, it prints the name and grade on the screen. Hope you understood the program. Hope this video will be helpful for you. Thank you for watching the video. Bye.